I hope everyone is good and taking good care of yourself. Welcome to the e-lecture of water supply for high-rise building for semester 6, year 3rd, and subject is building services. So up till now, in previous semester, you must have studied water supply for low-rise building, whereas you must have studied that water will get from main line, which is underground. And from that main line, first it goes to underground water storage tank, then to the overhead water storage tank, and from overhead water storage tank then it is supplied to the various parts of the house. So when it comes to water supply for high-rise building, the main challenge is to tackle the force of gravity, because water itself is a very heavy element on earth, and we are lifting water at a high level against the gravity. So in that case, we have to depend on some mechanical system like pumping system for this. So okay, let's start today's lecture. Of course, I'm just discussing very brief, and after this, maybe if you want more detail, I'm going to provide you a PPT which you can study for examination point of view, and plus if you are having any kind of questions, you are free to ask me. Okay, so let's start. Water supply for high-rise building. Depending upon the design of the building and height of the building and the location of the water storage tank, we may require pump room and various types of pumps to supply the water from UGT to OHT. Ideal pressure for residential or light commercial building is 2 to 5 bars. A bar is basically unit of measurement of water pressure. Basically, if a water pressure is less than 2 bar, it is not enough to pressure the shower. So if you are using a shower in your house, make sure that you are having a water pressure of minimum 2 bars. And if it is more than 5 bars, you are just wasting a lot of water. So ideally, the main concern as an architect is to have a water pressure between 2 to 5 bars. There are several standards to solve this challenge. For example, maybe we can use booster pump. Another option which is going to be used for many years is that we can use the water tank as rooftop and let the water flow with the help of gravity, so you can use it. But there is some challenges, because when I'm talking about, say, a building of having a G plus 5 floors, at that time maybe I can have a rooftop where I can ensure the water flowing through the pipe at the 5th floor having same pressure as that of ground floor. So there will not be that much of pressure difference, because the height is only G plus 5, say 15 to 18 floors. But when it comes to a skyscraper building, where the height is really, really big, for example, when you are talking about a building height of say 50 meters and somewhere around 80 meters, then this makes a lot of difference. In such case, we can use pressure reducing valve. And the technique called as a zoning technique, depending upon the various sizes and depending upon the various design of the building, there may be mechanical or plumbing rooms at different levels with a pressure tank in each to regulate the water supply pressure to each system. That means instead of providing a single water storage tank at roof level, maybe I can split that water storage tank into multiple small portions at various parts of the building. Now in first case I'm going to use a pressure reducing valve. The detail has been given over here, which you can see. Second system is zonings. That is, if I'm having a building of say 100 floors, I'm not going to provide a single water storage tank at roof level, but I'm going to provide 10 small tanks at various levels. That is 10 smaller tanks to tackle the entire water storage capacity. That is, I'm going to divide it into smaller zones, which is now become much more easier for me to handle. Previously, PRV methods were being used, and now in recent years, instead of PRV, zoning method is most popularly used. That is, you are going to divide it into multiple zones, vertical zones, so that every zone has its own dedicated water storage tank. So here you can see the zoning method diagram. For example, the water I'm going to fetch from water mains, then it goes to maybe break tank, or you can call it as a UGT, for instance. And then from UGT, if you see here, this building has been divided into three zones, that is one pump and one tank for zone number one, this is zone number two, and this is zone number three. So basically this entire building is divided into three zones. Now this, there can be individual water storage tank, or it can be supplied through pressure. On second diagram you can see pressure reducing wall, wherein after every certain floors you have to provide pressure reducing wall, which is quite not economically good and which requires a lot of maintenance. So instead of this first method is being mostly preferred. Now what is pressure break tank in water supply? Now this is something important to study and which is also important to know from exam point of view. A break pressure tank is a tank most reliable method of breaking pressure in bulk and reticulation water supply network. They are generally used in rural areas where little or no maintenance is carried out. Pressure tank are nothing but these are a tank where a pressure has been maintained, and in case of necessity the pressure can be broken so that water flow can be maintained. So a break pressure tank has fewer components than conventional pressure reducing installation, and there are many more things which you can just read out. This is the diagram, for example, which says this is the diagram which explains basic cross section of pressure reducing tank. The jockey pumps has been used in water supply system plus firefighting system. That is, jockey pumps are very much helpful for firefighting and sprinkler system. The detail you can see in this description. This is the zoning diagram where you can see the supply pipe. There are three tanks: underground tank, first overhead tank, second overhead tank, and the water has been distributed to each floor through the gravity. So this is zoning system which is most popularly used nowadays for high-rise supply. And these are the various types of water supply system. For example, if you see here, the water has been carried out first to overhead water storage tank, then through gravity it is supplied to various floors. In this second diagram you can see there is no overhead storage tank, but the water has been supplied directly from UGT to various floors with the help of pump. This is the same method. Here you can see OHT, from OHT to various floor levels, and here you can see group method. So it is divided into various groups. It may be OHT, it may be without OHT. So if you are not having OHT, you have to use pressure pump. Here you can see illustrated diagram. For example, this is water mains. From water mains it goes to a UGT. Of course this is gravity system and this is a pressurized system. So it goes to UGT, then from UGT it is being carried out to OHT, and from OHT it is being supplied to various floors with the help of gravity. When I see about the pressurized system, now here the water has been fetched from water main lines and pressure pump directly supply it to various floor levels. It might be low-rise structure, it might be high-rise structure. So that's it for today. In today's lecture we have studied brief about water supply for high-rise building. I hope you understood the concept. If you have any doubt, any question, please feel free to ask me. Take care. Bye-bye.